really cool position of power, and this is what we were expecting.
Yeah, there could be some really cool plays here as well.
Yeah, well, there's the Cannon Barrage, the flash forward. They're going to pick up the Caitlyn, deliver her back, and first blood over to Sangyun. That's exactly what Rox wanted.
Like, and double Zeal, Infinity Edge is mostly the way here in the LCK so far, as Crown takes so much damage from Lava.
Songwon's going to flash forward, but look at this. He needed to go Super Mega. Deathrock, it comes in and just destroys him. There's the Lantern as Key turns up at the right time, and this is why.
Two items onto the Jinx. Can they get anything out of her?
Not by the looks of things, as they do get the knock up. Isn't able to take the Lantern because another control ward is really nicely placed. And now Crown turns up to the fight. Lindarung right in the back line. This could be dangerous, but no, it's not. CoreJJ just going to bite the dust, and KSV have to get out. The flash forward from Key doesn't get the hook onto Crown. As Sangyu gets the impale, though, the Flame Chomper's doing work in the back line. Haru is going to be split up into pieces, and Lava just keeping the rest at bay. Cuve and Ruler, what can they do against this? Absolutely nothing. They can get hooked, though, and Cuve's just going to die. Bellow's Breath, not going to help you there. Now the flash forward from Sangyun. You know that he wants to get this one. Lava finds it as well, but he doesn't quite understand the range of Karma. Not that great. They'll just move back to the Baron, and that's exactly what Rox wanted.
They're going to get this one, and Rox Tigers break open the game.
Yeah, that Baron just evaporated. Purple Swirlies now on top of Rox to try and break down the rest of the structures. Feels like a death nail here for KSV.
The Flay stops the Elastic Slingshot. The ult does hit, but from there, they only get the QSS. Notice the Braum stun never hits, and then the re-engage can start. Lindarung walks up. CoreJJ first to go down, and then Mantra Inspire breathes doom into the hearts of KSV. Some abilities go wide. Don't know what he's thinking about the death sentence, but Skarner closed the distance. They've got a lot of speed up. And then Jinx stays excited. And that should also be excitement to Rox Tigers and disappointment for KSV, because suddenly this game is fully in the hands of Rox.
Yep, and it just feels so much like Game 2 yet again. This is the team fight that Rox Tigers
couldn't kill him with the Malzahar, and now we're looking at maybe the game-winning push.
Yep, Cannon Barrage comes in, but as the Inspire, it's not even getting through health bars at the moment with the Call of the Forge God, Cuve. They can't engage over the top of the Cannon Barrage, meaning that the tower just melts. They break the base of our already first place lock-ins and grand final lock-ins here.
We're laughing, but I'm sure KSV aren't. Second base turret going to be broken.
Yeah, it should be the second inhibitor broken as well. As Sangyun, he's going to head forward. The slowdown, the unbreakables looking pretty breakable in the hands of CoreJJ. Now Songwon gets himself out of there, Key keeping everyone safe. Sangyun even able to go into the minigun in order to lock down these turrets. Okay, Call of the Forge God does come in. Good play to get Haru out of there. The Desperation engage. Well, yep, Mantra Inspire is coming in as there's Haru. Gets a flash out of it, at least, as the Cannon Barrage does come down. A little bit hypey on the side of Lava because the play was really nice from Key.
Actually got some damage onto Sangyun. Used him Cure Scimitar just for movement speed. Doesn't matter.
Cuve in trouble, but here's another one. Another really good play comes down as Songwon. Not going to quite find the re-engage or anything like that, but Lindarung, he's playing frontline now as the Pirate, and Sangyun very low on mana, but it will be the last remaining inhibitor falling, and Rox Tigers getting a flash.
They pull
him all the way back in. See you later, Crown. Not a lot of options for clearing waves at this point, as Haru just really likes elastic slingshots, I guess. Here's the Call of the Forge God. They get a good knock-up onto Sangyun, but there's no follow-up damage there at all. Ruler, he's doing nothing to speak of. Cuve, he's basically dead here at this point. It's a double kill coming down. Now as Sangyun gets it, the triple, the quadra, and that's it. Sangyun is going to finish it for the Rox Tigers. Nexus turret's now going to fall, and off the back of the hugest Jinx ever, Rox Tigers deathless in this one, 11-0. They will keep those playoff dreams alive. KSV feeling really worried now.
You see the smiles. They know they are all but into the playoffs. They are not going to be crowned today for playoffs, but results have to go heavily against them, and they only have Jin Air to face in the regular season. So Rox Tigers stoked. KSV are definitely going to be on down in the dumps. Now they require SKT to lose to one of MVP or Kongdu Monster, or for them to beat Kingzone Dragon X. Both of those are tall tales KSV, since their series last week, had their fate in their hands. All we need is one victory. They lost to SKT, they lost to ROX, and increasingly, it seems like the world champions don't deserve to be in the playoffs.
Yeah, and this was a question you posed to me actually off air. You're like, what does it mean if our world champions aren't in the playoffs for the next season of LCK? And I'm finding it really difficult to answer the question. It's just really rough reading.
You would love
KSV
to
fans.
You definitely want the TSM legends or the behind the scenes stuff, because they kept all the damn players. It's the entire squad that won the world championships and that were very reliable, if not actual threats to the crown in 2017. They're always a good team in the LCK. For them to not even be top half, keeping the squad that won the world championship, is a mystery to us. But so often we've seen some pretty indifferent plays from them. And on this day, we saw a super-powered Rockstars. These guys haven't shown up on 8.4. 8.5 comes on. They only had Kongdu Monster to show.
Yep.
Now they have KSV to show. And Rocks Tigers finally correct the ship after a bad 2 weeks.
Yeah, it was clean. It was really nice from the Rocks Tigers in games number one.
Suffocating, I'm waiting and always hesitating. Kryptonite desires set my heart afire. Heart on fire. Set my heart afire. Suffocating, I'm waiting and always hesitating. Kryptonite desires set my heart afire. Heart on fire. Set my heart afire.